Welcome back, everyone.
Yes, we're into almost the final 4 hours of this 24-hour race on Kyoto Grand Prix Long. And it's been a long road, but I think it still feels like the quickest 24-hour race has actually gone. Maybe it's because it's the first one in years I haven't been involved in. I don't know how you guys feel about that so far.
It's gone past very quickly, and I'm actually surprisingly awake.
I must say, this session is just flashing by, to be honest.
Gotta say, what I have to say personally, just blabbering on about things really helps get really helps with staying awake.
What?
Yes.
Beans.
Potatoes.
Eggs.
Masturbation.
Must be hot.
Oh, don't bring up our knees, Jesus, no.
No, we've had Mattias Nielsen in our team.
What, and Carl's at the edge just now. It's Conquest Amina. Guida rejoining her with a new car.
You're not having the best of luck, are they?
No, I think they're their second or third timer.
It's unfortunate for them. I mean, they had the pole position in hand by quite some margin, and they got what turned right at the start.
Got turned at right at the start. Yeah, they were one of the first. One of the first lap victims from the M class. Yeah.
I think. Well, that put them way down the order, and they've never managed to recover from them.
Ironically, they're running right in front of their pro car. Which has also not had the best days, and also had two timeouts. I remember when Conquest raced in MOE and they had this skin where with no disco, no fails on the roof. It's ironically enough didn't time out in that race if I'm not wrong. But slowly, soon, approaching the 20-hour mark, and we're just over 4 hours to go here in the 24 hours of Kyoto GP, or the way I described it before the race, the way too long race I didn't want to be a part of. This is way long, but it's actually seemed a lot shorter than I thought it would be. Still too long.
Time is relative.
Time is relative, boredom only.
Well, time's relative until you start.
Well, the Infiniti Pro Esports amateur car going side by side there with the 55 car. Seems like on this lap, Infiniti amateur car seems to want to make contact with everything.
Team Virus, which is in pit lane.
Team Virus, Hutchin? What?
Team Virus is 58.
Ah, but Dovio is in pit lane, yes. My hearing's gone somewhere. But it's certainly not with me right now.
going by the tracker, the gap between second and third does not seem much at all. It's about 4 seconds now or something like that.
Second and third, they're definitely still pretty close together.
It's one of the most fascinating things with a 24-hour event is that cars can still be that close after doing so many laps.
I'm not even sure if it's that fast because it can't have happened in every single race. But every single 24-hour race, and people go on about how fascinating it is. But it's always the same, just it only happens once a year, so therefore it's got to be fascinating.
Well, sorry, I'm not German, so when I have an opinion, it's filled with emotion and enthusiasm rather than just a robotic sense of pure logic.
It is logic. I'm very sorry.
I don't like logic.
Every fast 20-hour mark. Yay! Go hours. Count down even further, or up, or one way at least. Make it end. Oh, what the virus? Amka! Did he hit his teammate? You might have done. But I wouldn't put a bet on it. There was certainly some smoke, and,
...62 in AM classes in the pit lane, which gifts us the third place in AM for the moment. Oh no, wait. There's a lap between us.
No. You are third in AM, or you're not?
No, there's a lap between us. And on that catastrophic failure...
Oh yeah, hello there, guys.
I bid you good morning. Because I need to warm up.
Okay. See you later. Bye. Yeah.
So we've got a returned Oscar. Also.
Indeed. Sorry, I was just discussing.
Returned Oscar. You mean someone bought him and
yeah,
and put
back.
Want him.
They said sorry. Wanting money back just was not worth it.
And the same player for safety because Steve is back at the camera control.
I unfortunately was having a discussion about a different racing league that I'm involved with and a few going on.
We had a
discussion
about WEC, so it doesn't matter.
I would have liked to have a discussion about WEC, although me and Steve already did that.
Kind of.
It's not mine.
Contact right before
Schneider's in Bobby House! How did they manage that?
Probably because the virus Amcar's got a bad luck magnet, given certain...
And Schneider's has got some... I'm pretty sure he's got a repair damage. Because he's got no camber on that right rear tyre.
Oh, that's looking ugly.
Look into... Well, you probably can't really see it, but...
No, I see what you mean.
When you get an angle from the right side of the view, when you get to see that, you can see how much the
it's flat
the right
the side
rear
of the car,
is carved
isn't it?
In. And yeah. it actually has positive camber now. That's probably almost insta-pit stop there.
Yeah...
No,
he's going to carry on.
Maybe you didn't notice it yet, but...
Oh, he's also got even more car than the right front wheel, I've just noticed. Looks very weird, that car.
Yeah, well, he's obviously just sideswiped the wall on the exit there, just flat on the side and boxed his wheels.
What about 58 damage, though? What about... Well, it's even more deformed than it was, but...
Well, the back damage
works.
Was there before.
I think the front's a bit more put.
Yeah, the front.
Other than that, it looks just like before.
Dommy, explain to me why the genuine racing car doesn't look beaten up enough.
Because impaired damage.
Well, yeah, that, obviously.
Because we care about how our car looks, so we want to present it in a nice and undamaged way on the stream, you know?
Yeah, Schneiders is currently finding out that his damage isn't any fun.
Yeah, he's...
In fact, Hillen's joined, hasn't he? So that's...
Yeah, so that's, yeah, as an insta-pit stop. Insta-pit stop, insta-throw, away suspension, insta-put new one in.
Yeah, 50 seconds and brand new car.
I think Audi did a gearbox change once in 10 minutes at Le Mans. And then they banned it, well, the ACO did. Because it was too quick.
Yeah.
What, didn't they make it the rule you couldn't change the case of the gearbox anymore? I think that was normal, wasn't it?
Yeah, you can use it, open it, and change everything within.
But you must keep the case.
Yeah.
So if, say, you start firing, you know, gears or sprockets or whatnot out of the bottom of your gearbox housing, you're in trouble.
Yeah, you're in trouble, yeah. However, the most metallic bits that have been fired out of the other mechanical bits are mainly jet engines lately.
What, just the pistons out the top?
But they weren't that good like in Le Mans, like as Pescarolo discovered.
Yeah, didn't they have all problems of, almost
I think
immediately?
I think almost all of theirs blew up. That's six engines for two cars. One of them ate so many up that they had to use the reserve engines from the other car, which meant the other car didn't have any reserve engines.
For when it blew up? Not unlike, say, Peugeot when they blew up all of their cars in the same hour a couple of years ago.
That was 2010, and I think they had, apparently, if I'm not wrong, the explanation for that was, the Conrods failed of all of them.
I'd suggest a redesign.
It was the faulty batch of Conrods. According to Peugeot, obviously, it couldn't possibly have been
a miscalculation on their part.
No. Just like blocking Audi for 4 or 5 hours. No, that can't be. No.
In all fairness, we all know that Ferrari just hire themselves out to the highest bidding LMP1 team to crash into the other one.
Ferrari?
Yes.
No, just the LMP1 cars always crash into Ferraris. And because the LMP1 teams are the factory teams, they blame it on the GT teams, and then that's the commonly known opinion. That crash, true, for example, Nish had. How was that? That GT's fault. That was completely his fault.
Well, I'm a Ferrari fan, so I don't know why I'm saying
it. In hour one of a 24-hour race.
I like Ferraris. And I like Ferrari Formula 1 teams, so there.
Back to the jet engines, they also failed in IndyCar massively.
Oh, barely. I could eat anywhere. They were so competitive.
Not unlike the Lotus engines in IndyCar.
Those
were good.
There were never any Lotus engines. They're just Jut engines with a Lotus badge on them. It's all that all Lotus does, except for building, making cards from old canoes and bits of fiberglass, is putting stickers on other cars which aren't theirs, and then owing the teams a lot of money and not giving it to them, and making a lot of people angry, and then looking like a massive bunch of fools in the aftermath. That's what they've done in the last 2 years.
British manufacturers.
It's Morgan have done it properly. They've put their badge on a thing that actually works.
But it is
an
made
LMP2
of wood.
LMP2 chassis.
Probably.
Certainly not made for wood. No, that LMP2 chassis has no bit of wood in it.
No, but all their road cars do.
I know.
They're made of old Dorset cottages. It's probably not true, but hey, I'll go with it.
If they are.
Yeah, What if they're just, and you know, removing the homes from people in the British countryside and grinding them down into cars?
What if they're made from glued together floorboards?
Well, you say that in a joking way, but that's actually more probable, as Vires have had an off at turn 10.
The AM one?
Yeah, the AM one.
Yeah, the AM one.
Yeah, they've reversed it into a wall again. It looks even more worse for wear.
Now it's even more deformed on the rear. Very pointy though, on the right side. You've got to be careful, you could cut yourself on that edge. Oh well, World of Real Life is even more bizarre than this race.
What's more bizarre than this?
Real life race, because there's actually money involved in manufacturers and organizations like the FIA and the ACO and SRO and no longer IMSA and NASCAR and IndyCar.
That's a shame, because I quite liked IMSA.
But, well, they've been. But NASCAR was IMSA, their competition for us. Bye.
Yeah, bye.
It's just the bike is
just put DPs with LMP2s, remove LMP1s from the equation.
It's not gonna happen. You know, for sure reason there are gonna be no P2s.
Yeah. That's what I was saying. It's like they can make the merger as much as they want, but all of the LMP teams are gonna go Grand Am's bye. That's all that's gonna happen.
I think they're gonna kill that thing anyway. There's gonna be no globally relevant sports car racing in America within the next 3 years.
I don't know why they're changing what they've got, because what they have currently is two very popular and separate series.
Yeah, but one bought out by. Well, it's not the series that's been bought out, it's the whole of IMSA. They've bought everything, they've bought the whole lot.
Why have they let some rednecks buy something that's actually decent?
Well, because they have no money. If I'm not wrong, the ALMS had to sell Motorsport in the last couple of years. Hence why it got renamed to the Canadian Tire Motorsport Park, or whatever it's called now. And I think another track as well, I'm not sure though. But they
don't forget this leasing contract about the naming rights, was yearly in these days. Was not no longer a multi-year deal, but yearly.
But the ALMS did a great thing, but they just ran out of money.
Is ALMS presumably running this year?
Yes, it is, but with P2 girls from the looks of it, because not a single one's ended for the full season.
I wonder why that is.
Not GTs. Lots of GTs. Some P1s.
Well, that's good, because all anyone really cares about is the GTs in ALMS.
Well, there are going to be lots of teams. There are going to be Corvettes, Ferraris, 997 Porsches, UZ4 GTE, and Aston Martins.
Yay! Presumably because it's a GT3 Aston Martin, GT2 rather, no. Aston Martin is going to have the V8.
It's the V8.
Yeah, and Aston Martin currently spreading their cars all over the Le Mans series.
Which is nice.
We've got four fat cars at the WEC as well for this year. Hey man.
Well, four is at least one more than they had last year.
Yeah, but they're not as bad as they, of course, because they've got seven.
Yeah, but the rate at which they crash
at
into Audis.
Well, they're not into Audis.
No, they're not. It's Toyotas now.
Oh, they'll crash into them. And then,
oh my god, next year it's going to be a Porsche. Best message.
Well, I would love if Porsche crashes into a 991 next year. That would be the best thing ever. What happened? We crashed to ourselves.
Uh, back to the actual race that we're watching. Battle for 6th is trying to get in the way at the moment between Sunin and Haley.
Was put a couple more Nenanens there than there actually were.
Sunin. I think I did it fine.
But the way he docked was so sudden. I have. Yeah, definitely a very close battle for 6th place at the moment between Core Pro 2 and Stick Breeding Program Pro. What if I just pronounced the Pro and Program more than everyone knows that it's the Pro Kill?
No.
And then the Am entry I pronounce Program, Progre, Am. Oh, is that too ridiculous?
I don't think this is really working.
Stig Breeding Program Team. And the Stig Breeding Pro entry.
Pro entry.
Pro entry. Extra Pro. Super Pro.
Stig Breeding Program Blue Mirror.
Sure about that one.
And that I've not actually had a great number of suggestions on renaming of the core.
We have a puncture, and the Am has a right front puncture.
Who? Cipolla.
They're now coming through the last couple of corners. It's 59. It's your team,
it's
Oscar.
It's me. Of course.
It's you.
Tyre has rain quit before the end.
I didn't know I was in the race. Something rage quitting.
Didn't know you were a tyre supplier, Oscar. What would your slogan be?
Slogan would be never give up. Unless you're doing shit, then definitely give up.
Like your team boss or something.
How about Oscar's tires? Last fewer laps than you would ever expect.
Yeah. Black round Pirelli's only worse.
You could be Paul Henry, I'm pretty sure.
Meanwhile, Virus, what's in the pit lane?
The one that's actually in second.
Yep.
After two car in second, unfortunately we don't have the one car in first because there's no one.
And currently Jenna is in third.
Lagging like who knows what.
A Stick Breeding Program might now get some help by all the traffic Core Car has. Virus is not really giving room in Virus amateur car. But he has the quadruple slipstream. No, triple slipstream. Maybe a bit. and the bleeding problem is through the traffic. Same call right in front of me. Some half second to be distance between those two. And when the 530 next car ahead. Those two looks like it's a Cola from Green Egg Industries. No, Savage Simple. Yeah, Savage Simple. So many green cars on the track. Sunan gets around in the goody chicane. And Supola cuts it, so the stick breeding problem car is also having no problem at all. Maybe a little. But the gap is increasing, I guess. At least it feels like that. The gap increased to around a second. Yeah, it really looks like the car is now losing contact to... Oh! The session just started. Good news for everyone, we know this race has started. Troy is demanding a drive-through penalty for Deco.
So, as Deckard has just pointed out on the server, the race has just started in the 24-hour race of Kyoto Grand Prix LOL.
Yeah, and actually, I don't know if you listened to me, Troy was demanding a drive-through penalty for chat-chatting.
I think it's only fair.
Slapcon, technically in here, and the last but not least one, Procon. He says he was lucky that he didn't spin there. Quoting him from his livestream.com/AlexO. He's already in the closing stages of his final stint. People are asking if a pit stop is required in this race. Well, no one forces you to go to the lane. But I think it's better if you want to finish good. Don't you think so, Chris? With about 3 hours 30 minutes to go, we give you a wrap-down of positions. In the lead, still in the lead with over a lap NX Racing. Current driver is Mikko Maruluto. Then there is Virus Racing in second position with Pekka Rajanen. Genuine Racing in third with Hyman. Fourth, and this could be a potential battle, maybe not. The gap increased of past that. Terra Mine Factory in fourth with Felix Hirn. Fifth is Ixion SimSports Pro with Otto Tuskinen. Sixth, Core Racing Pro 2 with Suninen. Then Stick Breeding Program 2, they have been pretty close to the core car, but the core car now pulls away, so the car doesn't have the pace, it seems. Vortex U with a great comeback in this race, having been dead last in the early stages of the race. Now in 8th position, come by this Pit Cannon. 9th, Conquest Racing Pro with Tomczyk. Team Rock Racing with Joe Lazzarello. 11th, Core Racing with Mike Parley. Let's see if he makes a movie out of this race. Then coming to the stick breeding program, amateurs. There you can compete in the amateur class with Russ, I think, driving. Hellenic Racing Team lost their massive lead they have some 10 hours ago. They are in 13th position. 14th, Green Angus Racing won with Chaka. And then the track of fans for me. But it has returned. Then there's your team, Oscar, with Hydinia driving in 15th overall, 4th in class. The 16th, Savage Sim Sports 1, Cipolla. Conquest Racing Amateurs with Guido. Scuderia Gas Racing with Medinas. Team Virus Amateurs with Doriots. And in 20th, Green Angus Racing 2 with Kevin Boyd coming. 21st is Savage Sim Sports 2 with Carl Reutzer. Last Lap Motorsports, Amateurs with Mayer in 22nd, followed by their pro team with Yantia driving. 24th is ASAX Motorsport with Gupta Top. 25th and last currently is Team 6A Fondo with Vida. Then we also have two retirements. Infinity Esports Pro, last driver was Dennis Lynn, who parked the car with, at that point, some 88 laps behind the car in front. There have been some connection / management issues, I guess. And then we've got Merida in listed here in 27. He retired, Merida Racing Team retired from a flip of Christoph, and the World Cross Lions didn't attend the race.
Still great to see more than 20 hours into a race that this many people are still running.
Yeah, especially now I knew how this would turn out with safety cars and the rule that once you have to shift P or shift S, you're out of the race. I mean, this is quite a premiere.
Car 22 and car 11 have taken collision into the final corner, and I think sure that's for lapping. No, it isn't. It's actually a battle on track, guys.
Oh.
Wow, this is battle on track.
About to be ruined.
Is some pitting.
But they're both at the end of the set, so it should be okay. They're both coming together.
Oh, but Vortex exactly. Should manage to
Madden
get a lead.
He's gonna jump.
They go. He goes. I'm shaking down the inside of Pete. Pete defending hard. Very, very late. defense and maneuver there for Peeplin. Oh, top ship sticks to the inside. A little bit of contact there again. Side by side, up the sweepers, down into this double sweeper. He's got the inside line this time. I think he's going to get the position up.
Contact!
Deliberate contact made. But they get the place.
Very close to both going off. And Tom Tick's probably trying everything as far ahead as possible to make up a rapid stop time that he's going to lose.
And Conquest. Imagine the Vortex was just in front.
Also, I just saw, which has nothing to do with it, but I just saw Picaron have a massive lockup in turn one. Wonder how, if that's any good to his, anything good to his turns, and my guess would be no.
I think everybody's guess would be no.
Kevin Loy entering the pit lane, presumably to take another stint.
Vortex go. Yeah, and Tuskovich is just going to be behind.
Ooh. So Tom Jig did some good work there.
Ivatsu is
going to... contact.
Oh. Who's going to get off the limiter first? It's going to be Ivatsu. Slow reactions from Conquest.
That's what you get in the SNR. You can't exit faster than that.
Well, no, if you spool up the turbo, which you obviously do, and you're ramming it off the limiter in first.
And now the Conquest takes over the car. Kevin Loy's day is done.
Indeed.
He's probably done it himself.
But I don't think he can actually drive any more. And no, physically obey the 33% rule.
Yeah, exactly. He's going to violate the 33% rule.
As we can see in his stream, he's now. First action he does is taking some water.
I imagine in this battle between Vortex and Conquest, I'm thinking Conquest might come out on top because Daskovich has been the faster of those two today.
Well, it's going to be very interesting to see over the last 3 hours and some minutes, 20 of them, in fact. Doesn't look Daskovich is just going to let him drive away and then catch up later on. He wants to be in front now.
Daskovich has some lap times where Yavatsu has been the more consistent in the average lap times.
Then Yavatsu is also better damage, so.
And he's tempter.
If I'm not wrong, the Conquest car was one of the fastest down the straight, so it will be interesting to see how they perform there when they get the chance for a draft.
Not unlike right now. Hopeless is the answer.
He was just out of outside of the slipstream.
Well, he's actually got, relatively speaking, quite slow straight line speed, as Tommy says. Oh, and he's made a mistake there. That's way too much curb and grass.
Looks like the compost car is out of reach, can't it?
Oh! What? Hi, Jaman. I think he just... I'm not sure whether that was really his fault. But he seemingly just turned around the 21 car.
I just flipped back to look at Mihaly recovering from something.
I just saw a massive wave of tires flying everywhere.
Sounds to me like a HRT F1 pit stop.
It's more like the kind of old tire stacks, you know, when they didn't bundle them together yet, and they were just three stacked on top of another. It flew around everywhere when someone drove it.
Well, Daskovic Jovansu is back underway.
Hi, Jermaine. Just ran into him, unfortunately. I think Mihaly was caught behind Littorito. He'd been blocking him for several laps. I think Mihaly just ran wide and Hydra just sort of slid up into him. Unfortunately,
I don't think it was really his fault. It just ended up, well, being what it... What happened? Oh God, Letteriello! Don't do that.
This is why I said last night that Joe is the craziest person in the team street. You can see now from his driving.
Maybe now where he's on stream for once and people don't just hear that he's driven.
Daskovic and Jovansu is hungry yet to hammer Togs. Yeah, Daskovic has got a better run out of the final corner this time, down the main straight. Here we go.
It's just
switches to the left hand who thinks about defending.
Car's got no top speeds whatsoever.
Yeah. Is he just going to run out of top speed? Has he found he didn't have enough time to cut back? I don't think he is, because he's... Yeah, so job done, surely, for Daskovic, yep. Well, no, he's left a gap!
Oh my god.
Suddenly gap, so job not done, because Jovancu's going to be right back at him down the run down to turn number 3-4. He is, he goes to the outside, Daskovic doesn't defend the inside line for the kick, he wants the inside line for turn number 4. I think he's a bit too far back to break him there.
Too far.
He's going to try.
Nah, he's going to try.
Oh, lovely driving. Your Vantage goes wide though, and Daskowitz is just gonna make it sticky. Your Vantage's got the quicker car off the turn. But Daskowitz has the inside line for the next corner. Up the hill they go through the sweeping bends toward turn number 9. Your Vantage, I think, will get the better run again with this XR top speed. He's understeering in the draft, and it looks like job done there for Conquest. Lovely driving as a turn four for those two though.
Not side by side.
Vantu try and stay as close as he had to. Oh, he's actually gaining through the spoon. Will he be able to keep it on the exit though? That's the important thing for him, to get a toe down to the British gate. He's running wide.
Just something I noticed over the last couple of hours. Is it that the Axadar has a slight advantage there on the apron? Because the FZRs usually go much, much narrower around that wall.
Yeah, possibly, yes. Your Vantage is actually back on him. Is he going to have a dive?
Oh God! Oh God! Why did we this?
Sorry, I pressed the button there. I think that actually put Daskowitz off because he ran wide into the corner himself, and Yovantsu got the toe back. So that was a good drive from Samson Yovantsu in the attempt to put Daskowitz off, which he's done. He's going to have the straight line speed and the toe, and he's going to sweep back around the Conquest car. You think Daskowitz moves slightly to the side, doesn't deviate his line. Daskowitz,
I think he's going to try and get it back on the second straight.
Now, roll reversal from last time. This time it's Daskowitz who's behind your Vantu down to turn number 4.
He's stayed close enough.
Yeah, he has indeed, Domkang. He
certainly has. Nice line.
Flying down, he'll take the inside. Your Vantu will. Your Vantu goes to the inside for the kick, and that was a good dummy there from Daskowitz. And he's down the inside, he's got the place back again. Your Vantu tries to cut back, and he's going to do it!
Your Vantu's going to do the switchback. There we go. Back through again.
Up the hill they go. This is lovely driving from these two, absolutely on the edge, but a lot of respect being shown at the same time.
Except they won't give me a heart attack.
Javansu offline.
You've had to very wide turn number 9, he's going to get sideways.
He's going to get halved.
He's going to try and think about into turn 10. No, he's got nowhere to go. The big arse of the XRR of Yovantsu, letting no width be given for the slightly slimmer bodied FZR there. It's like an American and a European trying to fight into a McDonald's.
I think the FZR's actually made that, to be honest.
Okay.
The FZR's the arse car after all.
He's got the draft.
Oh, surely he's going to be able to outbreak him here. I mean, that's FZR territory breaking.
He does.
Oh,
you managed to stay there, though.
Oh, no, we've had this situation before in the race. It always ends up this way.
Still going,
still
though.
Still not over.
Vance, if you're thinking, I think he'll wait until the main straight. He's not thinking. He's going to go for it now.
Whoa. To the inside.
Wow,
and
that's
and
slow back
again.
Down.
And now the next grid.
Daskowitz backing off. This is the longest back that so far.
Yes, Samson Yovantsu just will not give up to the slightly quicker at this point. FZR of Conquest Racing. Yovantsu stays to the inside. To the outside goes Daskowitz. Downward turn number 1. Surely this time he might have more of a chance. Yovantsu going to go down the inside for turn 1. That would be strange. And this battle is over.
That's sorted.
He's been chopped off there, that's done.
The first time in the entire battle somebody didn't think about their next move.
Just on the last lap, Javansu was 4 seconds slower than compared to his fastest lap.
What, that?
Towards Daskowitz.
That XRR is actually tracking to the left a little. That wheel's not anywhere near straight when he's going down the straight.
Be normal if it was iRacing. Wow, they didn't take any chances there. Who cares, it's still 3 hours from the race. If Conquest pull away, that's surely going to be their position. Depending on who's going to be next in that car, or if they're going to even make a driver change, because I believe there are some people mad enough to do 3 year stints in a row.
I mean, we have had this in the early part of the race as well.
When I'm on the 4 row.
Yeah, and Dennis as well, until he found out. The unlucky birthday kid.
He's probably having a good time now, or maybe not, who knows. Okay, up that, is there anything of relatively high relevance?
Well, you can have overlapped genuine racing.
But that's not the first time I've spent.
Yeah, it is the first time. So only the top two are on the lead lap now.
Oh yeah, but yeah, actually. It'll be very interesting to see how that pans out with the pit stop, who's going to end up on the lead lap and who not and why and where and up, down, left, right, centre. Maybe there are some team going to have a splash and dash at the end.
Hidal was having some off-road actions.
To be honest, since we're now 21 hours in almost, I can actually say there has been a surprisingly small number of timeouts.
Yeah, it looks like the server and then of course the driver's connections have been pretty solid.
Yeah, very much so actually. And if, well, they're the, I think the 15, the top 15 or 16, no, the top 15 cars, I think, all have not had a time.
You mean in the server?
Yeah, in the server. Of course, some we had a couple once, but...
Thinking of that, I remember a 24-hour race, I think it was the only one I really was around as a commentator. The MOE 24-hour race, where we had a GT2 leading in the server because everyone else fanned out.
I can't remember that ever happening.
Just server side leading, not in the tracker.
But that's still never good. Not in MOE.
It was a night stint, so maybe, I don't know.
I remember in 09 and in 24-hour race, the GT2 car finished third overall. Because of the timeouts.
Is it better? Okay, I'm making things. I guess. Oh, Mako Mariluto having trouble laughing because amateur cars are around.
Oh my god, amateur cars are everywhere.
Yeah.
Where did they all come from? They weren't here at the start of the race.
At least you
god,
can see
now
them.
They drive into each other as well. Oh day, oh my days. Come on guys.
You've got people watching you.
So at the moment, at least, oh, just forgot what I was gonna say. That's very bad. Damn. Professionalism can use, but I can just mention Core Pro 2 is in the pit, so I'll seem like I actually know what's going on.
By the way, if you missed the start of the race, the first 4 hours of the race are uploaded.
In the first four parts?
First four parts means 8 hours.
But it's the first 8 hours? I mean 8 hours.
8 hours!
8 hours!
8 hours!
You can find them on YouTube if you go to youtube.com/LFSNDRTD.
Yes, you can definitely do that. You can also find the stream recordings of several other races, and I think of all the previous GT1 on World Series, right?
And also some vintage races.
What races?
So the Kurt Hundred broadcast completely.
Well, it's just all will be done.
Then the GT2 World Series from South City. The GT1 World Series. GT Amateur League from 2010. Round 1.
Oh dear god.
In very interesting quality because back then everything on Multi-BC.
A Multi-BC.
Which also got renamed meanwhile. Oh yeah, the blue screens of death, where we had to commentate on a blue screen. Great memories. But one must say, even that service improved.
We haven't had too many blue screens over this race. Actually, we had a total number of none.
Well, we could say we had a total number of 2 if we count in our tries to get a split screen running.
Oh, that doesn't count.
That doesn't count?
No.
You mean because
I've decided that doesn't count.
Because it was user initiated instead of
no, provider. Because it was completely unnecessary.
Ah.
When you have leaders being surrounded by lots of AM cars, that's way more interesting.
Actually, if you look at the tracker, it's pretty sorted. The top 11 are pro cars and the rest are amateur class, with one exception. There is last but most sports in 24. with that Prokov.
Not really a Prokov, is it? The match is of one pro driver, so it's not a pro car in that respect.
Theoretically, they could have started in green today.
Yeah, but then. Yeah. I'd rather have more pro teams than am teams. At least we have, over the last 21 hours, only had two retirements. We've still got 25 runners? Yeah. 25 cars in turn. And we are now officially past the 21 hour mark by already just 40 seconds, to be honest. The exact rather.
3 hours left in this race.
The one GT2 World Race left in this race. Oh, Latriello's in the wall, I think. There was some lag contact with, I think, one of the SPP cars. Yeah, the 21 SPP car just had a massive lag contact with the 06 DRXR. Wow.
That car slightly wounded. They're not too happy.
Actually, I thought it would be absolutely
destroyed.
Smashed in the wall. Seems to have somehow caught it or not hit it in a too serious way. Wow.
And Lazzarello goes to the pit lane.
His tire suggests he's not that far away from the end of his stint, if not the end of his stint. And Tommy Oscar has already joined to take over, so I'm pretty sure that's what he's got to do.
Yeah, he actually joined before the accident happened, so it was the lap where it was planned to happen.
Gave me a shock and a half. I thought that car could possibly be smashing into the wall and maybe even flipping over it.
Lag. Well, it was like contact that sort of snapped him round in that way, but Jones should have been miles out of the way as soon as 21 made any kind of move. He just wouldn't move for corners, and yeah, well.
I don't know, for me, it didn't flags, see a Joe. Contact, but that's maybe because I switched to it, so like, I just saw it happen, and oh god, I thought God knows what's gonna happen.
Didn't hit the wall.
So nothing's left in the booby chicane. After we saw all the chat being covered by some yellow flag messages from there. Villa takes the car over from Dorrit. So for most of the teams, there are just some two pit stops left in the race. Well, some of them have three.
maybe also a few people watching percentages of one sort or another. Hello, Joe.
Joe, blue flags are to be used as to let people through.
What?
That crash you just had, blue flags, you know.
Oh, I don't know why the hell he did that. I was gonna let him by, you know. Dude. If we're working
he's
with half
an engine. For goodness sake.
We're working with half an engine, man. Cars fly by without a draft. Tommy's gonna do the last 3 hours. So anything happened when I was gone, except for me get passed by 1,000 people?
No,
I just call that a very good drift.
You also missed the best battle of the race, though, if I'm wrong.
I did.
Yes. Doing Conquest and Vortex. That was somewhat entertaining, also.
So 2 hours and 52 minutes to go in this live from Kyoto Grand Prix. Long 24 hour race within the New Dimension Racing GT1 World Series, the first 24 hour race done by New Dimension Racing. Normally it's Masters of Endurance to do such things, but there's no Masters of Endurance 24 hour race this year, as the main man, Mr. Ben Keogh, is he's travelling the world right now, and he's currently in Japan eating strange beef concoctions. So good luck to him and not getting poisoned. Oscar Hardwick says he's eating dog testicles as we speak or something.
I think that's the wrong part of Asia.
Shit, sorry. Main Korea.
Okay, apparently Oscar's got his facts wrong. That's good then.
Well,
that's good to
that
know
on stream, they know.
Anyway, so...
And actually, you guys do know that Ben is actually at the Kyoto track.
What he said in
the he is the one waving when we cross the finish line.
I thought he's the guy who threw the tires at the poles back in the chicane.
Yeah, that's what he's doing. That's what he's doing. Dom's got it right. He's got quick legs.
It's not a very nice job. It's not a very nice job. You gotta be quick, otherwise you get run over by lots of GT1s.
I'm paying him very well, though.
Yeah, it's already the second 24-hour race within this year.
After the dope one, or the desire of patience to water up.
Yeah,
it's a dope 24-hour race, more like a cycling race.
Into the pit lane, call the third place team.
By the way, that race was won by some interesting in the NGT class by X40, a team of teamless drivers, more or less. And Terra Mind Factory was winning the LRF class.
Yeah, LRF.
And, well, the DLP, I remember many interesting streams from teams with webcams. Among them was Christian Kistner, where you saw that, the extra bit of beer had its effect and stuff.
I think best broadcast of all time is definitely the NGR birthday event. We were just chatting nonsense and we were waiting.
That was, in a way it was great, in a way it was the most woeful thing in the world ever.
It wasn't supposed to be serious. Racing was terrible.
Oh really, was it, Chris? What, it was a really clean event?
What was the FPM and some
STD.
TVO or something.
STD, and you kept making jokes about STDs.
I was hammered.
No one actually noticed, Chris, really. No one noticed.
Surprisingly,
yeah. Yeah, you didn't mention it at all either.
Oh, car puncture. Car with puncture at Scuderia Gas, I do believe, in 11th place.
On the server. Oh, went all massive damage, so they must have gone into a wall quite hard. Oh, God! Let's knock their ears there, or did they try to turn it with the handbrake? But they've made it but, back safely to the pit lane that way. Okay, Ben Keogh is about Innex make everything boring.
Mm-hmm.
He obviously wasn't watching the first 9 hours then.
It's very exciting there. If only it had been a 6 hour race.
Then they would have finished like 12th place or something.
Not 12th place, but probably would have had a very hard time winning.
Using all your skills you found today, Joe, to get the rescue car safely up the hill, are we? We should watch
sir.
This. Somebody doesn't have a puncture.
I'll be the
same. Since I saw a rescue car on track.
Do you remember that last that motorsports event where they crossed the track and the downward turn
no, no,
the west
no, no,
turn
no, no.
First.
What happened back then, it was, if I'm not wrong, it was the test race for the first GT3 Touring Car Cup season. And Dico Pantola drove into the pit wall, flew through the pit lane, hit one of the rescue cars, and that rescue car just slowly rolled across the track.
Yes, that's what happened, yes. No, they also had a rescue car or a safety car that went sort of along the track, sort of up the hills of West Hill, sort of coming
down
towards
the track, and then
the
there was a safety car period where everyone just stopped and crashed into each other because the safety car just stopped dead in the middle of the track.
Yes.
I remember my driving skills on the safety car. Rolling start for Elvis' car, I was driving on the safety car while admining. Not really. And, well, I noticed later on, oh, this is the green stuff, not the black stuff.
Those things just very long ago.
Demi Gods just ran the ultimate rescue car failure from Jonathan. What's his name? Jonathan Pickard?
Pickard, yeah.
2008 IGTC finale. The very, very bright mind of Jonathan Pickard forgot which way Aston North went and came straight out of the pits at Aston North. You know, the whole sort of pit exit sort of thing with the wall, went right around the wall and careered straight into the path of a car that was actually racing. Back to the race.
I remember when Pekka turned up on TeamSpeak on a Saturday for a Super GT race, and it just went into the race control channel and nothing happened for like 20 minutes until someone went down there and told him it wasn't the race and like that. And he just left.
Well, I just got told by Jack Atkinson that nothing beats Adams.
But he doesn't know where the left line is.
Yeah.
One of my safety car was in a 1GP race where I had to do the safety car and race trick at the same time. Everyone's favorite series in Elvis ever, the 1GP series.
What race was it?
I don't even remember 1GP or 4GP.
Was it?
I remember 1GP.
Aston.
Aston.
Wasn't 1GP where you tried to go without the traction control?
No. No, it was with traction control, and even with traction control, I spun the car.
The OWRL that Aston raced once a couple of years ago, where they tried to ban traction control, and well, they're still using it today, so that should tell you a lot of it.
I don't even remember ITC, and my idea to bring it back for one weekend of fun that somebody who's not too far away in this commentary box decided to take over and said, I'll do it, and then he never did it.
I don't remember that, so it wasn't me.
Who would that be?
At least I bring back the format to some of my club races I held last year.
Dingo! Chris, your cold's getting worse.
It wasn't even listening! I said,
it's
huge. ITCC, I said I wanted to bring it back for one weekend of fun last year. And then somebody else said that they would do it, and then they never did it, and they still say they'll do it.
Oh,
and
it's
never been done! Who would that
eventually.
Be?
Early 2000.
Early 2009.
Just give the job to SRO that did anything.
Good news, Emery, the Scirocco has been released.
For which game?
For the...
Assetto Corsa.
For, no, not Assetto Corsa, for Brick Racing.
That's Duke Nukem Forever.
Duke Nukem Forever.
That's the worst game in the world ever.
I think what should really happen is iRacing should try and get a deal for the Volkswagen Scirocco. Just...
I think iRacing should just shut down so people play proper Sims.
Aren't you a happy bunny that you weren't in it with the iRacing racing guys earlier?
I'm not hiding my opinion of them, I'm just saying what I'm thinking.
But the problem with iRacing I have currently is that this model seems to spread all over the simulation world.
But what, pay to drive whenever you drive?
Yeah.
Pay for the bad physics that are apparently better, but...
Well, what do you mean by spread all over the simulation world? Like, R-Factor 2 has it in a lesser format, and iRacing has it.
Well, R-Factor 2 doesn't really have it.
I thought about getting R-Factor 2, but I forgot. Is it worth it? Does anybody actually play it?
Guys, it's
good news.
Very
much worth it.
Good news. It's not the DC Sandero, but I can look out my window and I start to see daylight. Yay!
My god, guess then, what? The next year we just go outside.
James May went ballistic last Sunday on Top Gear.
But what I meant with it spreading over the sim racing world, well, in a lesser form that it is included in, what is it called, Sim Raceway, and also in a lesser form it is included in this race room experience.
Sim Raceway is the biggest waste of money I've ever come across in my entire life. Because it's just our fact that with mods, that costs money.
Well, at this stage, the problem with it is that it's early in its development. The ideas, the concepts, and the backing they've got are better than all of the other sims.
You're not gonna pay 30 quid for a sim that's early in its development.
Well, not 30 quid, you're not gonna pay a penny, but you're not gonna pay 30 quid for one car!
Or on a sim that's...
But that's the idea is more that you earn the money through doing the competitions as opposed to actually pay your money. Then that's your. That's on you.
Rather to R Factor, that's free. Well, it's not free, but I have it anyway.
Yeah,
R Factor 2 is
I don't want to be too quick to write off any sims in development or otherwise.
Except for Project Car.
Except for Project Cars, because I said Sims, Dommy. You obviously weren't listening.
Sorry.
MG R2 have announced a deal with Marussia.
Moving along. Why Marussia?
I do not know. The cheapest thing to get?
I don't know. At least they're going to be experiencing how much of a pain a car like that is to drive for people like Timo Glock. Timo Glock, if you think
Irish. Not anymore.
Not anymore.
He got bored.
Now he's in DM, and either he's gonna be good there or kill his career like all the other F1 drivers.
So I'm gonna go with kill his career like all the other F1 drivers just cause.
I wouldn't be too sure he's in a BMW and they're pumping lots of money into that series.
Well, BMW won last season, didn't they?
Yes.
Very much, they've won everything. They've won teams, drivers, and manufacturers.
So that went surprisingly well for a debut season.
No, because they're all in the same car anyway. It's just how much testing.
It's just they put different badges.
Actually, there are about 50 construction parts of the car, all the same across all the DTM Roots cars.
I don't even understand.
But they're not even cars made by those manufacturers, because they're all Italian. They're made by a certain company which is now making chassis for the entire planet, called
Except
Galar.
For Brandon.
Except for what?
Except for Brandon.
And anything decent in sports car racing. Because they can't do that, because they're Dallara.
Well, Dallara just want to stick to their F3. Because that works.
Oh, no, they're Formula Nippon, they do F3, they do DTM, they do IndyCar, they do GP2. Everything else in open wheel racing. They do GP2. They did the HRT in 2010. Actually, that was the GP2.
Well, no, looking at last year's F3 car, it was just a concept of an F3 car.
Just another F car?
Yeah.
Not gonna get any better of it, it's just more expensive.
They also just make do the GP3, they will do the new Formula 4.
Yeah, they're doing that as well. Also, what else are they doing again?
This, how is it called? This car on the on one level with the Formula BMW. Because the BMW is the only not Dallara car I can remember in the recent years in Formula Racing.
It's not built by BMW either.
It's by Nigal.
A French chassis.
Yeah, a French
an engine chassis. That's only been
Our leader's off.
Oh god.
Here's Merlito was spun again at the British Gate. Now, what caused that then? He was in the middle of traffic.
Don't know, he's gonna put himself under pressure from only being a lap ahead instead of a lap and a bit.
He's only a lap and a sector ahead almost, also. Yeah, he's got no chance to win at all.
Zero possibility of winning.
Yeah, clearly. Dallara is actually doing some sports car racing because I think they're building the tub or they're building something related to the Audi R18. Plus 10 seconds then.
Which did I not intelligently earlier suggest would have a V10 engine in? And obviously it's not had for quite a while now.
It has a 2.7 litre V6.
Yes. Which, really, I should just pay more attention to these things.
It had a V12. Then the R10, and it went down to a V10 and the R15, and then still maintained that in the R15 plus plus minus divided times plus minus divided times.
See, that's all it is. I'm just thinking because obviously the R15 was my favourite. I wish they were all that.
But they
that's
changed the rules
true.
In 2011. They took away most of the power. Which teams could somehow regain, but they lost a lot of torque because they had to use much smaller engines.
And the new cars had to be closed.
Every really properly new car, I think. Not evolution models don't have to be, I think. Like the R5 plus plus minus.
Well, that's definitely a great reason.
The HPDs are on the top and they've got a new car like every year.
Not true.
I gotta say, the close top. Now the HPD is actually the best looking open top car I've seen since the R8. And the R8 was actually a completely built by the Dallara car. So the Dallara Audi. Not just an Audi.
Well, it's another stream around this race. The stream of Kevin Loy, he's currently watching some Jamie Oliver.
But didn't know why.
So talking about some motorsport is not really the wrongest thing.
That's better than talking about bleeding Jamie Oliver.
Kevin, why aren't you watching the stream?
We're talking about diesel engines, that's why. By the way, the Peugeot on the 2011 regulations actually had a V8, so it went one better than the Audi. But I still didn't
know that. That's interesting, actually.
But still didn't win Le Mans. Everything else in ILMC, but didn't win Le Mans. The championship in ILMC, but didn't win Le Mans. And then just pulled out 20 minutes before the season started last year.
Yeah. Well, the thing was, the car was actually at Sebring for testing.
Yeah, they went to Sebring, they got a Sebring for a private test, and then, oh well, the program is no longer viable, and we can't pay for it anymore, so, no one cares. And they actually had a hybrid car developed that was there, and it never drove. Not gonna
sell it. Maybe a battle of tracks, sorry guys, between Seven Sisters 1 and Conquest Amateur. There's 56 and 68.
Indeed.
Chris Wilkinson thing is right up his chuff.
There we go, for a move in that corner.
That seemed to be going on not too badly.
That went fast.
It was an interesting weave.
No, Capal's not getting dropped from there.
I think he's more trying to get the car to the finish line and really
trying to get the car to finish line a couple of laps in a row now. Adventures! Chicane adventure! Yay!
Oh, there's a car with a puncture on the front straight. Who's that?
That's Major! 57's got a left front puncture after turn 1, so wow. That's even more good news for LLM Amateur.
Safety car standby and all that, I think.
I think he's getting to the pits. Oh god!
Oh god!
Yep, I suspected he's off!
He's got some momentum!
He's out of power!
People not understand the concept of punctures creating an inability to turn or brake.
Oh no!
Oh god! Oh, Dashkevich!
That was rather...
I think we had this in turn 9 early in the race. I think the TR car had a left rear puncture just where Major is now. Ooh, and he was being overtaken around the outside. That was unbelievable.
Jeff. I think you'll be safe from here.
Be okay from now, unless Inex protests him if he jumps the chicane.
what are they called Inex then?
By the way, the reason why Martin Kapal was not able to fight back in the scene earlier is that they actually have an engine damage.
I thought you were going to say he was moderating some posts.
He hasn't got engine damage, he's just adjusted his BOP mid-race.
And I shall tell you that there is Loikhead on the screen. Of Alex
L. Oh god! he's gonna spin! Oh, he's spun back!
Nicely done!
What punches are you using for? That's one thing. That off in the turn, whatever that one was really not necessary. He should have seen that one gun because he wasn't able to turn in the corner previously either.
And he makes it in.
Yeah, bang there. Not quite on bang on the mark, but
close enough.
That will do the job. The LFS mechanics aren't really that picky about the car positioning in the pit stall.
I think that's more like mechanics in the SRO sanctioned stuff than in F1 also. Like, they have to wait until the car's standing still to get to the car.
just don't understand the way they have endurance pit stops in 1 hour sprint race. It just makes no sense whatsoever. Could have just as well have four people changing the wheels at once, and they're already there. So that thing of Formula One has proven that works as well.
Indeed.
Two hours and 25 minutes left. We are on lap 565. Or on lead lap 565. No one else is on 565. All one lower a minimum.
Yeah, James Peace is now entering lap 564 and he is second. Jenna and Terramitha keeps constant at being around one straight long.
Not yet, joined at again. And it's probably gonna take over the Conquest car. Probably it's probably.
I think he's gonna take over 13 that racing.
I think he's what's gonna take over the safety car.
So the fastest man who has been here today is entering the car again.
Quite a distance away from the vortex car that he fought earlier, which was so far clearly the best battle of the race. We go, not
so
yet
two,
in the car now.
So 2 hours and 20 minutes to go of this 24-hour race.
I think I've chosen the server password for this race very wisely, you know. I think everyone who knows it will maybe agree.
Indeed, it's a good place to have it.
Missed
AS5, do you?
No, not really. There would have been less kerfuffle going on at AS5, to be honest.
Yeah, I think the Masters of Endurance is just stale. It's run by an old man called Ben, so that's always the most inspiring thing in the world, is it?
I think we should run it at Spa next time.
Spa and iRacing, good idea.
Not iRacing. Get into LFS. Surely there's gotta be some way.
Maybe we'll get it rocking.
Yeah.
Maybe an FTR will win a 24 hour race in GT1 class.
At Rockingham, I don't know. Rockingham's like a car track. In a way. Certainly got bits up to the next arm, but that's a machine. Don't think I'll live in a day where we'll see that track in LFS in a publicly available version.
It doesn't look good, does it?
Not really, no. I won't live to the day, which is more likely, I won't even remember LFS by the time it gets released.
Hope it'll be early 2009, it'll be early 2019.
I think early 2019, yeah, it's probably just been a typo. With 2 hours and 18 minutes to go, after, oh, Krompus just dove down for one of the Green Youngers Racing Girls, so that's a very late and very unfortunate timeout. I think that was the FZR team. But with the 2 hours and 18 minutes to go, the top three in each class are, or rather, top three overall, NX Racing, Mikko Merilooto, who is leading James Peast for the virus in the virus car by a whole lap, and Rob Neidemann in third, Virginian Racing. And then the top three in amateur is Stick Breeding Program and Hellenic Racing Team and Green Youngers Racing. All standings, up-to-date standings, are available on tracker.newdimensionracing.com. But obviously, the LF standings aren't quite that correct anymore after all those timeouts over the last 21 and a bit hours.
Thank you.
Robin Fiskots leaves the pit lane after getting the car from Mihan Ogoto for the leading the next racing.
Slowly but surely approaching lap 600 within the next hour and a bit. It's a lot of laps this race. It's all day after all. My opinion is way too long still, but I don't know. Gotta say, the bit from start to hour 20 went by incredibly quick. Did not expect that at all. Ever since then, it's been a bit harder to chew.
Yeah, definitely. For me, the first 4 hours here of my Sunday stint were very, very fast. Gone, and now it's a bit like an old chewing gum.
I believe it's almost 2 p.m. for me, which means that the race is ending in just over 2 hours. I can't believe I've been up the whole day. And I'm still not completely trashed. That usually doesn't happen, but well, I guess that blabbering on constantly does actually help. Screaming around every 20 minutes as well because someone's done something. Scott is about to enter lap 570. Which is another milestone towards the 24 hour race distance, which is gonna be more than 570 laps.
Yep. It's going to seem more than that. Except for if the world ends now.
Well, again, who's saying it this time?
Me. No one else.
Oh.
What would be if S3 was released right now during this race?
Be gone if GTA 5 was released, but that's been delayed to September.
Yeah, but I think it would be a problem since no one knew could connect.
Adapt would completely kill the master server just to put S3 on everywhere. It's not an R factor server.
Yeah, but it would need. But that, it would need a restart of the master server. And at the time it's restarting, no one can connect.
But yeah, that's usually more for a server, to be honest. If a server isn't fully booted up or online, you usually can't connect to it. You have magic skills or cables.
I mean, we've experienced something like that during the 5-year anniversary broadcast.
Like what?
That the master server went down and no one could.
Oh, exactly, yeah, now I remember. Well, still wasn't as bad as us of not actually putting the stream thingy of TeamSpeak into our channel, and we ended up talking 10 minutes perfectly fine, and no one ever heard it.
We actually could have a bath of the wind in the amateur class developing, because apparently Steam Breeding Program had some issues with their driver changes, and Hellenic Racing only appeared to be 11.5 seconds behind them now.
Yeah, that's something to look at.
Still bussing around.
Indeed, they are very, very competitively. A very good job, I would say, from Hellenic Racing yet again. The ethics are experts of the moment, it does appear. They've taken over TDRT's mantle.
take no Kibiati's existence, and I haven't seen them for god knows how long. The last time I was in the RT car was my GTC in 2011.
So many dead teams.
KDRT targets first motorsports.
First racing.
Auric, Okrana.
What are you gonna say, Auric?
Both starting with the low.
Okrana wasn't really dead though, because they all joined SK.
Yeah, but
then SK died.
The big thing was the SK Gaming, yeah.
We won memory race because we did one stop left.
I'm surprised no one else had that idea in that race. I can still not believe it.
Funny thing is, yeah, after almost everyone was doing it.
Infinity also had not Infinity. Faculty. No.
Oh,
Infaculty.
Yes.
Now I get it. Also one of these multi-gaming clans with a racing department. Actually, that saw a brief reboot with new drivers, but that died as well.
Just kept running away, it got new ones, then Oza ran away, it got new ones, and then Oza ran away, and they got fed up.
Yeah, pretty much like that. I remember Nylon was there for a bit.
Ah, oh, yes, but that was ages ago.
Yeah.
That was before he was in SK. And he was, I think it was even before he was in the Krana.
Yeah, but he won the ESL Pro Series for Infinity.
ESL Pro Series for everyone. Probably even for his neighbors.
Yeah, I mean, the winners list was not that big, at least not with different drivers.
Very Red Bull-like, to be honest.
Yeah, then we had Vikush winning it once. But that was under S1.
Hey, S1, where you go, where you get more grip in a front-wheel drive car, the faster you go around the corner. In any car, really, not a front-wheel drive car. None of these cars I've done before, so it's not that. Before you tell me that I'm an idiot.
And of course, LFS being that big that time, that the was on television over here.
Well, I mean, it's always that big deal. My god, iRacing 2WC went $10,000. I somehow think, you know, BMW M6, even if it's 1 year old, it's going to be worth a lot more than $10,000. That's something you could win by driving LFS only 5 years ago. I mean, that's insane. Now you can't win anything.
You can win a sandwich for Deco Jester.
Just another thing I might have to throw away.
Yeah, that's true, there are massive amounts of money involved in the speed somehow.
Somehow?
But, yeah, somehow. I remember it being promoted on various game-related websites, for example, when AOL was still something big and not what it is today.
No one even knows what it is anymore.
Yeah, apparently no one knows what it is. Back then it was a provider for the internet, over here in Germany at least. I don't know how it was in other countries, but they had a relatively up-to-date gaming site of their own, and they were reporting constantly around the speed.
Back then they were to report about Live for Speed, you gotta give them that as well.
Yeah, true. I mean, this year is the 10th anniversary of LiferSpeed.de.
To the 11th anniversary of LFS.
And yeah. That's, I think, the first ever German community gathering. Maybe planned. Who knows?
Erg the herd. Germans together.
Yeah, Bike is actually trying to set up something as far as I have read it.
I can't believe what my eyes are seeing, are just seeing right now. But
they see that we need to do another break. The final break of the day.
Yes, indeed. But isn't the last part gonna be over 2 hours then, though?
Yeah, but that's no problem.
Okay. Bye-bye!
Bye!